Oh, we just took the blaster out of the shed. As you can see, I unlocked it from the CR and the TTR. Now I could probably shove another bike down here, like my KX and my XR when it's done. I have another CR I can put down here. I got a bunch of bikes, if you guys watched my other videos. But I never made the last update. Well, I did, I just didn't feel like posting it because it came out really bad. So here's the last update of my blaster. It's done. It's been done for about a week now. I was gonna fix the back brakes, I just don't have time for it. And I just gotta put air in the back tire because I got a guy coming right now for it, and this tire's flat. It's coming from New Haven, Connecticut, so it's about an hour and 20 minute drive here to New York. So he's coming. He left at 3, it's 4, so he should be here soon. Just pulled it out of the shed. Figured I'd make a quick walk around of it. Well, when I got it, it had a blue frame that was like all chipped up. Everything, yeah, white on it. It looked really bad. And it had a stock, but it had a full FMF, and the A-arms were silver, just looked really bad. So I tore it down, put purple frame, yellow A-arms, yellow oil pump cover, yellow swing arm, purple carrier, purple rims, white hubs to match the white shocks, yellow bars, black plastic, black front plastics all I had. Had the white and purple seat, which is the purple seat's what made me want to do the purple frame. Got a little purple on this. Your front plastic, so it makes it kind of like blend. But yeah, it's got new front brakes, fresh top and bottom end. The crank was good, but it's got new main bearings, Buesco top end. It's got a DT100 header flange. And the old FMF I used on another blaster, if you guys go back to my other videos. But it's got a DG header DT125 header flange that I had to file to make it fit on the cylinder, but I got it to fit. And then the DG pipe fit right on because I didn't have a flange. Got a DG silencer on there. I put a 290. I was going to put a 300 main in it, but the guy sent me a 290 to 360. But he also sent me an upgraded pilot jet. So I just put the pilot jet in there with a 290 main. So now it's running a tad rich. Now I'm okay with that. So I figured I'd do a cold start while I'm here. It's been in the shed for a week. You can trust me, it's cold. Yeah, it's about half a tank of gas in there. Turn the gas. Pull out the choke. The choke doesn't hold itself out, so I'll probably have to hold it. Pipe's cold. You can see my hand's kind of red. Header's cold down here. That's the spring from my CR125 on here. Head. You can see all new gaskets around the motor. Reed gasket. I put the Vitos bolt kit all around the motor. Chrome bolts everywhere. Chrome bolts for the cylinder. Got them for that. But I got Boyesen power reeds, a uni air filter, new chain that I should tighten, but I'm not even going to worry about it. So, probably, 2003 clutch perch without the e-brake shit. And, what was I going to say, when I got it, I couldn't find the cable holder, whatever hell you want to call it. But if any of you guys don't have one, you guys want to get one. WR450s or 400s, I forgot which one it was. They, what do you call them? Those cable holders are a dime a dozen, so you can buy them anytime for like $8-$9. So I bought one. It was a lot longer, so I cut it. The hole was already here, so I just drew out the hole to fit, and then I was able to bend it to the side. You can see it's not perfectly bent, and then if you torque down the bolt tight enough, it doesn't move, it doesn't flinch. If you guys want, you guys can probably put a couple spot welds into the case with it. But it doesn't do anything. It doesn't offset your cable or anything, and it works fine. So I'm glad I was able to do that. It's got pro taper grips, stock bars, new front brakes and wheel bearings. No throttle, one pre-kick. Alright, that was two pre-kicks. Alright, let's just make it three. Alright, ready? Here we go. First kick. When I started this project, it didn't run due to it had no motor in it. It only came with a cylinder and a carb. So my goal was to make it start first kick and run nice. And it runs nice, but it always started second kick. So then after I rejetted it, I got it fine-tuned and idling good. It started up first kick every time now. And it's been sitting for a week. You can see it starts up first kick. I'm sure if it sits for 2 months and it's like 5 degrees out, yeah, it'll probably take two kicks. But as long as you kick it hard and have the choke out, it should always start first kick if it's tuned right. So So I'll talk to you guys later. This might be my last blaster video. If it is, say goodbye. It's an O2 blaster. Bye.